Lindy Starburst sprays are filled with color and shimmer, making them a must-have, must-use in my studio. In today's 5 Minutes of Fun video, I'm pairing them with Lavinia Stencils, which allows me to add shimmery texture and pattern to my tags, journal pages, and more. Wednesday's Midweek Muse video was creating magical mixes using Lindy Starburst sprays, Distress Oxide sprays, and Art Alchemy paint. Today I'm going to spend 5 minutes playing with just the Starburst sprays, and I'm bringing in the new Lavinia stencils since sprays and stencils are pretty much a natural pairing. So there were 3 new colors that I didn't actually have when I was filming, but nevertheless there are 3 new colors. So this is Bombshell Black, this is Open Arms Amethyst, and then this is Gag Me With a Spoon Gray, and you can see some samples of each of them here. When I create, when I'm spraying with a variety of things, but especially with something like the Starburst sprays, because I enjoy glimmer so much, one of the things that I like to do is what you see here, and someplace there's probably some other examples, where I spray a color, like I did here. I sprayed through, this stencil is named Buds, I sprayed through it, and then I turned it face down and printed what was left here in the green, and then sprayed through it again. So when I work, I do this quite often. I will do that because I like the two-color effect that you get. But in addition to that, I'm also going to use some tags, and these are our number 8 Smooth and Sturdy tags. I'm going to use the backs of some of these that I've already worked on as a mop-up thing. So really, at that point, pretty much nothing goes to waste. The 3 Lavinia stencils that I'm going to work with today are, this is named Coral, this is Stones, and this one is Orchid. And I'll start with that one because I haven't even used this one yet. So here's the process. Spray, turn and print, and spray again. Now you don't have to spray again, but I like the effect that you get when you do that. And then the other piece of that is you can mop up, which I will show you. So I have 2 Starburst spray colors. I have Poinsettia Red Gold, and this is Bio Boogie Gold, which might be discontinued, but with that said, it really doesn't make any difference because there are several other golds. Now, the mica powder has accumulated in the bottom, but it's a pretty quick matter to shake it and get that to lift up. So I'm going to start with this color. I want to make sure I get enough on there. I'm going to lift that up, and this is Orchid. It's a really pretty design. Let's toss that out of the way. Now, before I bring anything else in, I'm going to come in and start mopping this up. Now, I'm only using one hand because I've got the stencil held in the other. Ordinarily, I would put it down someplace, but since I'm going to come back and use it again, let's just pick up some more of this one with another. Since I'm going to come back and use this again, I'm not going to set it down because then I'll have to fumble around. So again, beginnings of backgrounds. Now I'm just going to take some paper towel and kind of mop up what remains. And I'll take a fresh tag. I'm going to turn this upside down and print it. And let's grab a fresh piece of paper towel. And I'm going to press. The key to getting a good print is, first of all, there's got to be enough spray left on the stencil to really make one. And then the other is to press to make certain that this comes into contact, the stencil itself comes into contact with the tag. So what I'll do now is grab the gold, and I'm going to go ahead and mist through here. Now the nice thing about this, when there's liquid on the underside of the stencil and you print, it actually kind of adheres to the surface, so you don't have to worry about that too much. All right, I am going to put this to one side. Let's get it out of the way, because again, too many things and not enough hands. So this is a little bit muddled. You can't see it all that well, but the effect that you get, and sometimes you discover that as you do this kind of thing, you discover that, well, let me find it, rather than really definite like this, sometimes the print and spray through doesn't come out exactly the way that you want. But really, nothing ventured, nothing gained. So let's grab this, and I can pick up some of this gold. And then eventually, when these are dry, I can spray through them with a darker color so that what's under the stencil, I'll see these colors, and then the spray is whatever color the spray is. So mopping up, let's swap over now to, this is Prima Donna Purple, and this is Drop Dead Gorgeous Green. I'm going to go ahead and give them a shake. And then let's bring in the Stones stencil, and let's start with the purple. All right, so there's that. Perfectly well done design. Let's grab another tag and kind of mop up the purple that's here. put that to one side, quickly wipe up what's left. Let me go ahead and print this. Again, same process. I want to press to make certain that I'm getting good contact, and then let's grab the green, give it a shake. Before I forget, one of the things that you should do when you're through is wipe that in spray nozzle so that it doesn't dry and clog. It will happen if you are not careful with them. You have to take care of them. All right, this is a brand new bottle that I just made, so it's going to take a second to actually get the sprayer, there we go, to start working. And I picked this up. See, now that one worked really, really well. I can see the green stones, and I have a purple background, which I think is really cool. So now what I can do, I'm going to tap, so I'm not going to make too much of a mess mixing, but I'm going to put some green on top of this other color. And again, it's just layers. It's the start of something else. All right, so that's stones done. Let's toss that to one side, go ahead and mop up, although I could have mopped up more of the green. Let's bring in, what do we got here? So this is Magnolia Magenta Gold, and let's pick Tibetan Poppy Teal. So I'll bring in the coral. Already got some purple on there. And we will use the Magnolia Magenta Gold through the stencil. Oops. All right. How pretty is that? Just a nice overall pattern. All of Tracy's stencils are kind of nature themed, so you know exactly what you're getting with this particular group. Really interesting designs. So there's the start again of something else. We'll toss that out of the way, mop this up, and then this will be the last one that I do, where I'll bring in the shabby turbine, the Tibetan poppy teal. All right, let's go and press that. I don't know how much we're going to get because I don't think there's a ton of the spray left over, but again, sometimes this works better than others. That's the nature of this kind of experimental play. You get what you get, and sometimes it's not what you thought it was going to be. All right, so that's shaken. There we go. Pick it up. Oh, I like that. I like that a lot. So this is the process. Playing like this yields lots of creative bits that can be used for other projects, whether I wanted to put this tag on a journal page, or maybe it becomes the basis for something brand new. With this much shimmer and color, along with the patterns from the Lavinia stencils, you pretty much can't go wrong.